Hey everyone and welcome back to a mining chamber video. In this video, I want to give you a tour in my mining garage so you can get ideas to implement it in your large or small scale mining operation. I will cover everything from the parts that I have to the electricity setup as well as the airflow. So let's get started right after our good old intro. The GPU mining garage, the cozy home for every miner. So first let's start with what I have going on here in terms of rigs, shelves and all that fun stuff. I currently have 5 mining rigs running in my garage. First is my baby Radeon 7, 6 of them, and then there is an assortment of Nvidia 3000 series GPUs, and on the right side there's an assortment of old AMD and Nvidia cards. Both are built on a AAA Wave 12 GPU frame, which they sent me a couple of. So if you guys want these frames, feel free to check out their websites. They are one of my favorite frames to use for GPU mining. And then on the right shelf, there is 2 rigs in the mine boxes from mineshop.eu. Guntus, the owner of the shop, sent me 3 of them for the garage, which was also super nice from him. And all I can say, these mine boxes are truly my favorite cases. So the first one in the shelf is empty, I have cards on the way to fill it up, and then the second one is filled up with 6 RTX 3080s and 2 RTX 3060 Ti's, and then the last one is filled up with the 850 700 XT's. I flipped the fans on these cases so that they push air in one direction, which I will explain more in the airflow section of the video. So I have these 5 rigs sitting on shelves that I bought off of Rona Depot, which is the Home Depot version of Canada. You can find these shelves in almost any office supply store, get ones that fit your farm size and then you're set. As for internet connection, I'm using the Nighthawk satellite, which connects to an Ethernet switch, and then that Ethernet switch is giving Ethernet to all the mining rigs that I have in the garage. You can also use a power line adapter to get the Ethernet when your modem is somewhere further away in the house. Just make sure you don't twist the Ethernet cables while you're managing them like I'm doing here. All of my rigs are connected to this PDU from Nerdgears, which Red Panda Mining gave me in one of our collab videos. I will talk more about the PDU and how it's connected later on in the video. And then I have the beautiful box wall where I keep all my extra parts as well as the boxes for my hardware. So now that covers the parts regarding to the mining rigs, now let's go ahead and talk about the airflow. So for the airflow, I had to think a lot about it and figure out what's the most efficient way to keep my mining rigs cool and in the summer not have to worry about all the heat that they generate. So the way that worked best for me for cooling the rigs is by opening up the garage holes on the top. So I have 2 garage doors, and then both of these garage doors I'm using one for intake and then one for outtake. So the one for intake is the one that's behind the rigs, and those will bring in cold air for the mining rigs. So I just took off the little screens and then I put on a dust filter on it, and then from there I can just bring in cold air and clearing out all the dust through the dust filters as well. And then on the opposite side of the garage, the other windows, they're just open without any dust filters, although it's preferably to add dust filters to them, but for now I have them without it, so they're just going to be pushing air out and then the air will be just coming in like a circle. So it will look something similar to what I'm showing you on the screen. And then I have all the mining rigs pushing the hot air towards the other side of the garage. So that's why I had to flip all the fans on the mine boxes, because these fans generally push air towards where the fans are, but I flipped them so that the air is pushed out towards the opposite side of the fan. So running it like this, I've been able to keep some really good temperatures, even though some of my GPU fans are starting to break down. So you can see here the temperature in the garage, and right now it's kind of chilly outside, so it's probably why, but in the summer it won't be that bad either, but we will see when the time comes. And then for fans, I have a couple of fans set up around the garage. 2 of them are pushing the air from the mining rigs towards the other corner of the garage where the air goes out, and then one fan is pushing that hot air directly up top to that corner. And then as for the electricity setup, I won't go too deep into this, but I'll just give you guys a rough idea of what I'm doing. So first off, the fuse box is in the garage, so it makes everything easier if I want to expand more outlets or anything like that. So the first thing I did is I figured out how much amps I have in this house in general. So in this panel, I have a total of 100 amps, and that means I'm pretty limited to how much GPUs I can run or how much mining rigs in general I can run here. So initially I wanted to do 3 30 amp plugs, and these 30 amp plugs are basically just really strong power plugs that can run multiple of mining rigs, not just one. And then that plug you would connect into it a power distributing unit, or known as a PDU. And then from the PDU, you connect all the mining rigs that you can on that outlet. So these plugs are generally 220 volt 30 amp, which means if you want to know how much power you can run on these, you just multiply 30 by 220 and then you only use 80% of the results. So now back to the fuse box, I'm only able to do 130 amps since I have 100 amp total in the house. Now in general, whenever it comes to electricity, you only want to use 80% no matter what it is. So now since I have 100 amp for the house, that means I only have 80 amps and I'm only going to use 80 amps or less. Now that includes the oven, the laundry, the dryers and all that fun stuff. So I need to be careful with my wattage and not draw too much power, which will cause the breaker to trip. And then unfortunately, when it comes to the breakout panel that I have, which is Federal Pioneer, it is known for not tripping properly and it might catch on fire if you use too much power on that panel. So if you have the same one, then please be careful. And if you're not experienced with any electricity stuff, please contact an electrician. This work is very serious and you might hurt yourself trying to mess around with the fuse box. And if you get shocked by the fuse box, then you are in for a really bad time. So please be careful. Now in this video, I'm not going to be talking in depth about how to set up a 30 amp plug or anything like that. But now you should know what you need if you want to run a garage mining farm or if you're trying to install one of these 30 amps 240 volt plugs and then plug into them a PDU. I will leave the links for everything in the descriptions below, including the plug as well as the PDU, so you can know for the future what are they called and how much are they going for. Now one thing I want to set up in the future for this electricity setup is this new awesome meter box 30 amp plug. Now this 30 amp plug was sent to me by a great guy that has a Kickstarter on this project and he wanted me to try it out and see how it goes, and so far first impressions on the product, it looks great. Although I didn't have time to set it up, I am waiting until I upgrade my panel before I set up anything else right now. So what this plug does, it's basically going to give you a live reading of how much power you're drawing from this outlet, so like that you know exactly how much power you're using for mining and then you can calculate your expenses based on that. It also comes with the cable that connects directly to the outlet. Instead of using a PDU, you'll be using these different cables that come out of this box, which plugs directly into your power supply. So you have a total of 4 cables that would plug into any power supply. The way you set it up is exactly like setting up a 30 amp 240 volt outlet. So you just have to wire it up properly from the inside and then it's good to go. If you want to buy one of these meter boxes, I will leave the link for the Kickstarter in the descriptions below. It's still in a Kickstarter phase, so I would really appreciate it if you guys go support the project if you can make use of the meter box. Now that wraps up the electricity setup, so that's the entire mining garage for you. And if you guys are curious of how it sounds like inside, then here's a little clip of the audio inside the garage. Now that is it for the garage. So for the future on this garage, I want to be upgrading the panel to a 400 amp panel instead of 100 amp and then get rid of this Federal Pioneer and get a better brand that's more safe and reliable. And then I will also be adding more fans for airflow eventually when I be adding more GPUs, because it will be getting really hot inside of the garage. Now that being said, I hope you guys learned something new from this video or just got a new idea to implement in your garage or in your mining setup. And if you have any feedback or suggestions of what I should be doing in my garage, please let me know in the comments below. So that is it for the video. If you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here. So thank you so much for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.